Welcome back. We're going to be taking a look at an all new kit from Academy Hobby Model Kits out of Korea. Model Rectifier Corporation sent this over. This is available on shelves right now. I will link where you could snag this from Model Rectifier Corporation at this exact moment, if it hasn't sold out, you know, when the video comes out. But it is a current production kit, and as of filming this, it is available and will be available. If they sell out, they'll get more in. 1/48 scale, called quarter scale by the modelers, just because a quarter inch on the model equals 1 foot in real life. 1/48 scale in a modern jet is a large model. This thing is almost 13 inches from front to back, 12.7 inches total all the way in there. So let's take a look at this all new kit from Academy. First thing, actually, we'll take a look at the box. When you pick it up, you can see the full color and paint guide, or if you want to get yours now, you can simply pause the video. They've got for Humbrol, GSI, Life Color, Testers Model Master, Revell, Vallejo, and AK Interactive, which means you could match that up to any other paint guides out there. There's a gajillion crossovers. So we will look at the paper goods of the model. We've got two entire manuals. This is a complex kit. It is not for absolute raw beginners that don't have any experience putting things together, but an adult should be able to get this together if they take their time. If it's your very first model kit, it will just take you quite a bit longer. You can see how detailed it is. Beautiful line drawings. They really get into it in Academy. I mean, this is highly, highly detailed. Do you see how you are attaching individual fins to the missiles? So let's talk about those missiles. In this kit, it will have two AIM-9M missiles, two AGM-65s, two GBU-54 JDAMs, two GBU-12s, two LAU-68 rocket launchers, one AQ-28 Lightning targeting pod, and one ECM pod in the all-new kit. You can also display the ailerons up and down. It will allow you to display the cockpit open or close, so I wanted to go over those features on that. Manual 2 will start to get into some finer line drawings of larger assemblies, and even color callouts on your assemblies for your landing gear to let you know where to place decals, where to paint certain colors, and then the color and decal options for the kit. So that's pretty sweet on there. And of course, they've got all the different parts trees. There are so many parts trees in this model. First up in the paper goods, aside from the manual, this blue sheet that doesn't look too exciting until you realize that no extra charge, they include a full window mask for the canopies. On these canopies and other detail parts, you have to get these really small frames painted in like they are on the real one, and those masks, you don't have to pay another 10 bucks to a builder. You can actually get those. Look at the size of this decal sheet. Ginormous. No detail left unturned. We got all of our cockpit instrumentation, all of our things there, if you don't want to paint it inside by hand. And then a billion no-step callouts, all kinds of scripts on there. We've got the flying tigers, the shark's teeth, which belong on every Warthog. It's just such a cool jet. So when they asked me if I would unbox it, even though I don't build a lot of these on here, I said, heck yes. But you can see all the different units on there, everything, all the different aircraft markings. You have a massive, massive amount of stuff to work on. We got the tiny little heads-up display here, right there, in clear. We've got the cockpit glazing. As you see, it's a single-pilot aircraft, or this version. Marker lights, pitots on there, pitots, pitots, whatever. Heads-up display, that little bent glass there. And you can see a little rivet lines and everything on the glass. That's what you have to mask off. So I'm going to grab the other styrene parts. There's so many of them, I don't have them on the table right now, and I'll come back in a second. Okay, from the other side of the desk, you can start getting an idea of the size of this aircraft. Now, I'm not a jet aircraft expert, so I will probably say the wrong parts, but you can see like the ailerons here that we can display up and down. Look at the molding detail on that. nice gray blue plastic. It's a grayish blue, so they're going to let you see everything on there. All the detail, I mean, just look at just my hand and the size of that one tree. You can see all the nice location marks when we assemble stuff. Nothing left. They got pins in here so you can line things up straight. I'm going to try to set all these trees off to the side while we go through them, because there are a lot in this. Now you can see the wings here. Look at the monster size kit you're going to have assembled. This thing's going to take up space on the shelf, but 1/48 scale is an extremely popular scale and also has a ton of ground support vehicles available in that scale. So the wings have lovely panel lines sunk in like a modern kit you'd request, but not garish or look like giant valleys. Very, very small rivet detail. You can see the openings for the ailerons there, so you can display them in the way you see fit. Look at inside, like the bays there. Look at that engraving. Outstanding. Now we've got some armament here. Looks like a tank. It's either a bomb or a drop tank. I'm guessing it's a bomb, possibly. But that's parts tree F right there. Small details. You can see even the fins on here. But you see that location mark there? You don't have to try to guess to line that up. They've got the mark right there for you. There's where that little piece of glass goes. Must be some sort of camera, vision camera. The little ball turret there. Wow. There's not much that they don't think of. Look at how small the parts are right there. Check that out. That's nuts. Camera can barely focus on it. I'm filming it 30 frames a second here. So we'll pull off this huge tree here. We've got fuselage sides where like the ladder would go, or access points for mechanics. We got our little ducts, they're molded in. Got our landing gear, support hardware. Check that out. Look at the detail on the ejection seats. Don't need to buy any resin seats. I mean, I suppose you could if you wanted. That's a very common thing. But the ejection seats, the ailerons and all that, this kit will build into a gorgeous machine right out of the box without a dollar spent. And you don't even have to buy masks for the glass. So there's that tree right there with the doors on it. We've got more. This kit would take forever to glue together if I tried to build it for the show quick. Nice detail panel on the side of the fuselage there. See, we got some smaller trees here. Look at that. Excellent. Look at the instrumentation cluster. That's so sweet. Look at these fins. They're just so small. They look like they're probably antennas or something. So what else we got? We want to see even smaller parts. I'm pretty sure that's the Gatling gun. Off the front end. Look at that. You gotta make the brrrr noise. But even the ends of the barrels are molded out. Got the nose to our fuselage with all of our equipment in it. We've got two identical, you'll get two of these trees. So if you screw up, you got two pilots you can work on. The pilot has lovely modern jet pilot detail. Got our engine fans, engine pods, small details. Look at the pilot's, he's even got thumbs. Look at thumbs on something that small. Look at the helmet. His head's two pieces. Right there and right there. That's crazy. More armament, more missiles. Your airplane experts will, jet experts will know. But you're going to get two of those trees like so. And then for the final large styrene pieces in the kit, we've got our rest of our fuselage molded in one piece. Slide molding is pretty amazing. You can see all the wings will join, where they've got the nice tabs that go in. And then they got the inset so that they glue in place straight and true. All the nice detail. Now at the end of this video, I will have still images of all these various parts, trees, and parts. Check out the engine pods for that fuselage. It's nice that that's all done in one mold, so it's seamless. locator, excellent. Panel lines all the way around. Pretty amazing what they're doing with modern kits. So I'm going to have photos of those parts trees of the all new, and I mean all new, United States Air Force A-10C from the 75th FS Flying Tigers. And I will see all of you at the next review.